altogether. My sheep hear my voice, says the Lord. I know them, and they follow me.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds and to his disciples, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You lock the kingdom of heaven before men. You do not enter yourselves, nor do you allow entrance to those trying to enter. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You traverse sea and land to make one convert, and when that happens, you make him a child of Gehenna, twice as much as yourselves. Woe to you, blind guides, who say, 'If one swears by the temple, it means nothing. But if one swears by the gold of the temple, one is obligated.' Blind fools, which is greater, the gold or the temple that made the gold sacred? And you say, 'If one swears by the altar, it means nothing. But if one swears by the gift on the altar, one is obligated.' You blind ones, which is greater, the gift or the altar that makes the gift sacred? One who swears by the altar swears by it and all that is upon it. One who swears by the temple swears by it and by him who dwells in it. One who swears by heaven swears by the throne of God and by him who is seated on it." My dear friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon, sisters and brothers in Christ. Peace and blessings to everyone. In every facet of life, whether in our homes, in our workplaces, in our churches or communities of faith, in our society at large, the quality of leadership or management profoundly influences the well-being and the direction of the people under its guidance. We have all been praying, desiring, not just for leaders, but for good leadership. A good leader who knows the way, who shows the way, and who goes the way. A leader who possesses integrity, inspiration, influence, impact. A leader who manifests compass, care and compassion for the people under his or her care. At the very heart of leadership, relationship. Leading the people with the heart, with the head, with the heart, hands, leading the people to holiness, leading the people to God, leading the people to become the best and the better version of themselves. In our gospel reading today, Jesus denounces the religious political leaders during his time, the scribes and the Pharisees, for their abuse of power, for their hypocrisy, for their heartlessness. Maaanghang ang mga salita at hamon ng ating Panginoong Hesus sa mga leader ng kanyang bayan. Why? Well, the religious leaders that time, they burdened the people with their legalistic requirements. Sinasabi ho ng mga guro noon, kailangan kabisaduhin ang batas. 613. Yung pinakamaliit na tuldok, Kuwait, dapat kabisado. You have to know by letter, the letter of the law, by heart. Pero ang mga leaders that time, they do not know or they do not live by the very spirit of the law. The weightier things of the law, mercy, justice, and love. Sa totoo lamang po, kapuri-puri rin po yung mga leaders that time with their zeal. Masigasig po ang mga Pariseo, ang mga eskriba. Masigasig, masipag, masunurin. Pero sa kanilang puso, sila rin ay mapanghusga, mapagmataas, makasarili. Zeal. On the one hand, zeal is good. But zeal can also be misplaced. It depends on the motivation and the manner of zeal. Well, ang mga Pariseo, mga eskriba, sila talaga ay masunurin sa batas, masigasig. Pero ang kanilang pagiging masigasig, in the direction of pagiging masigasig sa panghuhusga. The zeal of the Pharisees and scribes is not inspiring. Their zeal devours. Their zeal destroys. And this is what irked our Lord Jesus. My dear friends in Christ, we all pray and desire for good leadership. At the very heart of leadership, relationship with one another. You know, in the first reading today, it has a different leadership style from that of the scribes and the Pharisees. Saint Paul, as a leader, values the person in every community. He thanks them, he encourages them, he prays for them. That is what a good leader is all about. The power of a leader, the authority of a leader, does not reside on its power. But the real power, authority, resides in empowering people. That is the greatest strength of a leader. Empowering people. Not only creating followers, but creating more leaders. My dear friends, we continue to pray for all our leaders, even as we celebrate today the National Heroes Day. A God-centered leadership possesses the creativity of God the Father. A leader who possesses the peace of Jesus Christ, peace in the midst of conflicts, A leader who possesses the passion of the Holy Spirit, the mind of a manager, the soul of a teacher, the heart of a servant. At the very heart of leadership, relationship. More than simply aiming for success, a leader aims for significance. More than simply profit, purpose. More than speed, it's about substance, the real stuff of life. My dear friends, today as we celebrate the National Heroes Day, we pray for all heroes. Yung katabi niyo ho ba, nakikita niyo ang kabayanihan niya? Bayani ba siya? Well, iba-iba ang klase ng mga heroes. Everyday heroes, extraordinary heroes, heroes who wear capes, heroes without capes, celebrated heroes, unsung heroes. But the real hero is someone who simply makes this world a better, a safer, a more humane and holy place to live in. Amen.